I live in a small wire cage my entire life.
No one loves me. No one touches me.
I live in filth.
I cry for help,
but no one comes.
No one cares.
When I get sick,
no doctor comes.
No doctor comes.
I'm scared.
I'm forced to breathe at every cycle.
My children are taken away from me,
and they are sick.
They often die.
I am America's dirty little secret.
Dirty little secret.
I am a multi-billion
dollar industry.
I suffer for human greed.
I am a puppy mill dog.
There's a lot of people out there that have heard the word puppy mill, but they don't really know what it means. To see and experience what a puppy mill really looks like, what a puppy mill feels like. Rows and stacks of cages. In each small cage, four or five dogs, one male and three or four females. Absolutely unable to comprehend human interaction. They're untouchable. You know, they cower to the back of the cage, extremely terrified. Did nothing but try my hardest not to cry. To see it in person and to experience what it feels like to look in the eyes of the dogs on the other side of those cages was life-changing for me. And the passion that was brewing inside of me right then, just hours after being in the puppy mills, I would not rest without doing something about it.
I am the parent of the puppy in the window.
When you buy a puppy from a pet store or over the internet,
you keep me here. You keep me enslaved.
Please love me.
Please help me.
When you stop buying,
I will be sad.
I've got a sweet, sweet female who's 5 or 6 years old, really laid back, very sweet temperament. One little thing, she's missing her back feet. Her mama chewed her back feet off when she was born. So I said, can she walk? I mean, what? Oh yeah, she gets around. So she's bred this dog like this for 6 years with no back feet. I mean, it just, you know, it just, the mindset is just, you know, where do you stop? Like, what, you know, what is not okay with you? Maybe she should be pregnant and have somebody cut her feet off and see how that feels. Do you really think this is an okay thing to do to this animal? Where's your heart? Do you ever look in their eyes? I look in their eyes. Did you ever look at her and not think about dollar signs? Did you ever look at her and think about whether or not she's comfortable? Did you ever look at her and think about her laying next to somebody's feet in their house as a part of their family? That's tough to look at. Somebody's gonna love her so damn big. A lot of people are gonna love her big, but somebody's gonna love her big enough to take her home and make her a part of their family.
Ziva's life will not be in vain. Where I have a really, really sweet, very nice-tempered female, about 5 or 6 years old, very gentle personality and whatever. So I thought, oh, okay. And she said, well, there's just one hitch. She's missing her back feet and her tail. Her mom bit her back feet and her tail off when she was born. So I said, oh, okay. Obviously, right away in my mind, I'm thinking, we're taking this dog. You know, I asked her, can she walk? She said, oh, yeah, she gets around. Okay, so called our truck and our transport, and I said, you know, we've got an extra one to pick up tomorrow in Kansas. And, you know, if she doesn't have back feet, they can put blankets in one of the kennels for her and stuff. So they picked her up, and boy, shortly thereafter, Daryl, our transporter, called me, and he was furious at the way she handled her dogs. He said she was literally just tossing them in the truck, careless, rough handling her dogs, to include the little Keishan that had no feet. She, stuck her in one of the kennels on the truck, shut the door so fast she shut the door on her stumps on her back legs, you know, and he was yelling, ah, their feet, you know, and she didn't care. And, you know, you would think with us as a rescue, you're turning your dogs over to us, you know, maybe you would be a little more gentle, at least around us. But so she clearly absolutely did not care. Here's the dogs, goodbye. It was truly a lesson in adaptability. I mean, she really, Keishan's a medium-sized dog. She really didn't use her back feet at all. She just walked very balanced on her front feet and occasionally would put her back foot down just for balance, but not for motoring at all. You know, and it was just looking at her and thinking, man, you know, my gosh, she lived like that in a pen. I'm sure she was just out in a pen her whole life. She's 5 or 6 years like that. And, you know, the adaptability, the acceptance of that, I mean, that's something I think we can learn from dogs, you know. Oh, got 2 feet, I'll use those, you know. She just captured a lot of hearts, and I mean, we immediately were getting applications for her, for people that wanted to adopt her and give her a loving home. She was unique, though. She was just unique in everything about her. Was gentle and kind. She's very timid, but also very soft natured, and very, you know, don't hurt me, you know, but she loved to be held. And her heartworm test came back very, very strong positive. In other words, as soon as they put the reagent on the blood, you know, as soon as it wicked into the test, it was positive right away. We've never seen that. That's a real heavy load of heartworm. One of our volunteers that does the medications called me early Monday morning, and she was crying so hard I couldn't understand what she was saying, and I knew she was at the kennel because I could hear the barking. And, you know, that obviously immediately worried me, something's wrong at the kennel, and, you know, it's a, Susan, you got to tell me what's going on. And she, you know, I could hear her say, Ziva, Ziva. And I said, well, what's the matter, you know? And she said, Ziva's dead. And I'm just telling you, my heart sank so hard. I just thought, oh my God, can you look at her for a full minute, make sure she's not still breathing? In my mind, as a nurse, you know, if there's one thread of life left in her, we're going to save her, we're going to fix it, you know, whatever. She deserves so much more. She's only had 5 days of being in a place where nobody gave a damn about her. She has all these people that want to give her a great home. I don't know any other way to say it. I'm pissed. You know, we don't lose a lot of dogs. It's surprising, really, because some of the conditions they come in are really bad. But we're always able to help them. You know, we just are always able to turn them around. It's very, very infrequently that we lose a dog. So I think that's why she hit me so hard. One, her overall condition, her fighting spirit, the fact that people wanted her. She was just that far from a loving home. She just was kind of like Lily, our founding dog. She was just like her all over again to me. You know, how could you have lived like this for so long? You know, being so used and so uncared for. Your life will not be in vain. It will not. And that's what started this organization. And Ziva to me was that all over again. It's time for people to wake up. You know, this is not right. You know, seeing a puppy in a pet store, oh, it's so cute, this and that, you know. This is not cute. Mommy and Daddy are not living a cute life. If these people who go out and buy a puppy in a pet store spent 5 minutes in this building, I guarantee you they would never have made that decision to do that. You know, never. There are ways to go about getting a pet that don't support this industry. shelters, rescues, responsible breeders, they exist, of course. Ziva's life will not be in vain, just like Lily's was. It will not. And I will make it right for the rest of the dogs on that property. I will do it with the authorities or without them. I really don't care. It's going to happen. Ziva came to us, you know, this enchanting, kind, sweet, soft, beautiful dog. And today, I picked her up. This is Ziva now. And I promise her, everybody, and most especially her, her life won't be in vain. The fact that she only had 5 days of freedom will bring thousands of days of freedom to thousands of other dogs. And I just thought, I'm so sorry we didn't come sooner.
I didn't know. Didn't know you were there. And I'm sorry.
Your story will be told. And I hope you felt safe and loved here for the few days you were with us. Just this side of heaven is a place called Rainbow Bridge. When I get there, I'm going to be tackled by a lot of dogs. And I really hope that Ziva's one of them.